got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedom.
Well, hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. We're looking at my website. It's been a long day. We're looking at my website on the live show page with the newest change, which is just awesome. And I'll tell you in a minute what brought about this change, but I mean, it falls in line with everything I'm always trying to do. Work on zero budget. And if anybody questions anything, because there is a donation there, you can request my PayPal statements from here to hell and back. That's fine. I'll give them to anybody that asks if you really think this is about any money. So anyway, I'm looking for free ways. That's why I'm using YouTube. I'm looking for ways to secure the site. That's why I'm broadcasting through YouTube, because you're not going to DDoS YouTube and shut me down. And I tried using Skype and Google together to give more access to people, but that just sucks, and it really causes audio issues, and it still leaves out a major part of my social network, people that want to speak, man, and that's what it's all about. So fuck your system. I'm going to be using free conference call. And this is pretty awesome because it isn't supported by ads. You're not going to get spammed with ads when you call into the show, okay? It's free for me, so there's no cost. I don't have to ask you for donations to pay a phone bill. And the greatest part of it all, if you know anything about me, it's because I love you all, no matter where you are, and I want you all. You're all welcome here on my site, on my network. Your voice is welcome. And now, boom. Because of this service, any country, I mean, I don't know how many's here, 26, maybe more, count them, find yours. You can call into the show. You can be a part of that. And this was prompted because earlier tonight, you guys know about the mayhem around Million Mask March, outside of what I've been talking about. And because of what I've been talking about the last month or so, obviously there's a lot of butthurt and a lot of foulness going around and a lot of confusion. Some saying that I'm trying to cause division. I'm really not. I'm trying to find out the truth. Anyway, tonight John Anthony Fairhurst was given an opportunity to speak in rebuttal of what I've been doing. Not that I've censored him or stopped him from giving me rebuttal before this, but he was invited on Friday Night Super Show. And before I say anything about that, I want to say shout out to Dennis Ford for trying to keep it real. I have nothing against Dennis. He's never changed his spots, like I said on the show, the few minutes that I was allowed to talk. Now, at the beginning of the show, Lee, Mouth of the South, apparently a drunk, states that, you know, he's there and he doesn't like censorship and everybody's going to have a voice. But when it came to my time to rebut anything, John spewed and ranted and backed up all the stuff I'm trying to say about his aggression and his inability to lead and him being the reason there's division. And I didn't know John before this. This is not personal. I've never met the man. Do I want to? No. Although tonight on the show he did basically threaten me if he ever saw me, which is fine. You're welcome to come to my house anytime. Anybody is. But beyond that, between John and Lee not allowing me to even finish what I had to say, and I wasn't attacking in any manner, that audio is out there. I waited on the line over 45 minutes just for the opportunity to speak. And when I disagreed with Lee and tried to speak to him about that and give my point, which never got across, main point being we can lead a peaceful revolution and change this country. That has not been taught to the people. Look at Iceland, and I don't want to hear any of your bullshit. If you believe that we the people are the ones in control of the government, then you must understand that if we the people decide it doesn't exist anymore, it does not. It's as simple as that. But anyway, Lee bounced me off the show. And so, this provoked me to do this. So we've cleaned up the Skype-Google issue. Nobody needs to be on any of their accounts. They can call in. There may be some, you know, if you're calling from a home phone, there may be some long-distance charges even within your country. So I can't say that it's free, but, I mean, if you're on a calling plan, your cell phone, you're not worried about those toll charges anyway, and so probably that applies worldwide, and I hope it does. I hope nobody has to pay to call in, but this will make it more accessible for more people, and you need to be, it needs to be more accessible, because what's going on in D.C. is also being replayed throughout the entire world, and I damn sure am not going to sit by when I see a movement that started to bring everybody together slowly destroy everybody within it. I'm not going to do it. I don't care what your opinion is. And I'm not going to have to threaten, yell, scream, or anything else to do it. People have made claims that this is personal. There's some of you out there that understand, really, if you want to be truthful, that this is not personal. Because if it were, and I would just release all the screenshots and all the audio and all the things I have that I've collected in the search of the truth, this isn't about any one of you. Sorry to hurt your feelings. You're not my fucking priority. Okay? And I'm not going to be censored. I mean, I do this because I don't want anyone censored. And so we're going to talk about the Million Mask March. I have one guest that may surprise many of you, but she's not off the hook yet either. Wiki poet Christine Ann Sands has agreed to come on. We'll see if she follows through. It's been hard communicating with her. And no, I still don't have a clear picture of her, and no, I don't still have a document to prove exactly what she is. Those are very hard to come by. But my opinion hasn't changed. And I'm going to treat her with the respect I would treat anybody. I'm not going to threaten her or be foul to her. But we're going to talk about some situations that's going to be uncomfortable for everybody involved. And why would I do this? Because the state of my country is at stake. The state of a movement that I fully believe in, i.e. Anonymous, is being torn apart. People are riding its coattails for profit. And they're shaming something that finally brought the whole world together. If you think that I'm going to see that happening and I'm going to stand by silent, you don't really understand me. And it's about fucking time you did. I've done everything within my power to show everybody exactly who I am, including doxing myself on video. My social security number is out there, my birth certificate. I'm just a fucking guy who's had enough. And I see things that I don't think most of the people see. You can disagree with me, but you're not going to threaten me. You're not going to censor me. You're not going to stop me. So anyway, let's get on down to it. Sunday night, shall we? 9 p.m. on the West Coast, 6 p.m. on the East Coast, right here. Master of Many Things Live. Chat through Chat Tango. You do not have to register. You can remain anonymous, as you see some have chosen to do in the past. Yes, if you get out of line, I could track your IP, but nobody else can see that, and I'm not worried about that anyway. Don't troll my show. Don't give me the opportunity to bounce you, but say what you got to say. That's fine. If you flood, then, you know, if you're a real outlandish asshole, then I might have to do something about it. But if you're just there to converse, share ideas, information, you'll never have a problem with me. I don't care if you disagree with me all night long. You're welcome to stay, and that's fine. And you can call in. We can have up to 1,000 callers on this, folks, and it is only has a limit of 6 hours. So we're not going to be on the air 6 hours. I'm thinking, you know, probably 2 is the average live show, but we won't be restricted by time. If we need to go into overtime to let everybody speak, then we will do that. And depending on how things go and what time, you know, because I want to give everybody else, you guys kind of get where I'm coming from. I'm going to give you some more information. I may have some screens available. Those will be available. Anyway, they're available now. I just haven't shared them with anybody. Because, again, it isn't personal. But if anybody feels the need to call my bluff or question me, I'll back up every fucking word I say. I'm not here for anything but the truth in hopes of waking a few people up before I go and making sure my kids see what I'm doing, and so they'll continue that. Okay, that's it. Beyond that, zero fucks. I love you all, but ultimately everybody's an avatar. You've got to understand that. And it's a hard row to hoe, they might say. Anyway, so Sunday night, link's going to be below. You can get to the international numbers there if you want to already have them punched into your phone. There's links to videos and stuff. If you do find it's worthy to sponsor the site, this isn't just Kevin taking a donation. You get, you know, some more attention to your causes. We give shout-outs. Right now, we don't have any monthly supporters, by the way. But I haven't been doing a lot of live shows either. I'm hoping to do more of that. But again, I work full-time, so it's hard for me. But anyway, I'm going to get out of here so you guys will get back to what you're doing. Much love. Many thanks. Sunday night. That's 48 hours, folks, less than 48 hours. Sunday night, 9 p.m. on the West Coast, 6 p.m. on the East Coast. The links you need will be below. I hope to see you there. I hope to hear your voice. Much love. Many thanks.
You've got to put your body upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop. And you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless...